Every year on St. Patrick's Day, St. Patrick comes down out of heaven and goes to an Irish pub somewhere in the world. This past St. Patrick's Day, he went to Murphy's local pub. So Murphy walks in, there's St. Patrick sitting over in the corner with a big green bishop's mitre on his head and the green robes and the crozier staff and all the snakes around his feet. Murphy says to the bartender, he says, is that St. Patrick sitting there in the corner? And the bartender says, yeah, he's just down for the day. Murphy said, well, I'd like to buy him a drink. And the bartender says, he'll have a pint of Guinness. So he sends one over. O'Brien walks in, said to the bartender, is that St. Patrick sitting there in the corner with a big green hat on him? And the bartender says, yeah, he's just down for the day. O'Brien said, I'd like to buy him a drink. Says he'll have a pint of Guinness. So O'Brien sends one over. Casey walks in. He said, is that the patron saint of Ireland himself sitting over there, St. Patrick? And the bartender says, yep, just down for the day. If you want to buy him a drink, he'll have a pint of Guinness. So Casey sends one over. Well, St. Patrick downs the three pints, and he's on his way home. He's leaving the pub, and he walks over to Casey, and he puts his hand on his shoulder, and he said, thanks very much for the pint. That was very generous of you. And Casey says, well, my arthritis, I was crippled with it for years. I'm cured. Thank you, St. Patrick. And he walks over to O'Brien, he puts his hand on his head. He said, thanks very much for the pint. Very decent of you. O'Brien says, wow, my migraine headaches, had them for years, they're gone. Thank you, St. Patrick. And he walks over to Murphy, and Murphy says, don't touch me, I'm on disability. Murphy and O'Brien had a skinful to drink on St. Patrick's Day. They're driving home in the car, and they decide to open a couple of bottles of Guinness. So they're drinking these two bottles and driving home. All of a sudden, they look in the rear-view mirror. There's the old red and blue flashing lights on behind them. O'Brien says, it's the cops. What are we going to do? Murphy says, don't panic. Peel the label off the bottle of Guinness and stick it on your forehead. O'Brien says, what? He says, peel the label off the bottle of Guinness, stick it on your forehead. So they peel the labels off, slap them right on the foreheads. The cop pulls them over, walks up to the window. Murphy rolls the window down. The policeman looks in and said, have you gentlemen been drinking? Murphy says, no, no, not us, officer. Look, we are on the patch. You know, one of the things that we have in Ireland that's slightly different from what you do here in the United States, you know, when people come out to a bar and have a few drinks, you have a designated driver to help get them home. In Ireland, we have something similar, but not quite exactly the same. And I'll illustrate. Just outside of Galway, there's a place called Salt Hill. There's a great pub called Teddy O'Connor's. Now, Teddy O'Connor's got in trouble with the law last year for serving drinks after hours. And just like here in the United States, it's illegal. So the police were clamping down on it. Two policemen and an unmarked car sitting across the street from O'Connor's pub. Now, the pubs in Ireland close at 11:30. So at 11:30, the pub doors open, the lights go on, everybody appears to leave and go home. But the cops aren't fooled. They sit, and they wait, and they watch. Sure enough, about 3 o'clock in the morning, the pub doors open, a head pokes out, Murphy. Looks up and down the street each way. Comes out of the pub, staggers across the street to his car, fumbles with a lock, gets into the car, starts it up, and takes off out of town. Well, the policemen take off after him. After about 30 minutes, they finally pull him over, and they get him out, and they run all the sobriety tests on him, standing in one foot, closing his eyes, touching his nose, saying his ABCs backwards, and he aces every one of them, passed every one with flying colors. The policeman looked at him and said, you're not drunk. Murphy says, no, I am the designated decoy.